It's the research covers up the fact that it's highly, highly individual. And my own research, which was much more qualitative, like with the individual women who I've worked with for years, in the transition to motherhood. And what I found is that there is a certain kind of, not exactly personality type, but if you have been a high achieving, maybe perfectionist sort of career woman, the transition to motherhood can be very, very hard.
Very dramatic.
Very dramatic, and no one is going to give you an A star for being a mum, whereas at work you can climb the hurdles and you can get the A stars and get the promotions.
Yes.
So often those kind of women are really unhappy at home. It's a crash.
Yes.
And what you're saying about the celebrities, I find, you know, there's this kind of idealization of perfect motherhood, like you said, without us realizing the army of helpers
makes
that image possible.
Yes.
So women are kind of racked with guilt, you know, damned if you do, damned if you don't. So what I say is you've got to do what is best for you.
Absolutely.
And so that, you know, because a happy mum makes a happy baby.
Yeah, definitely. Yes.
And it's all about finding the right juggle, really, the right
what
balance.
What was your sort of your own personal experience? Because you've got two children.
Two children. They're now 17 and 13. I've kind of done everything. I've been a stay-at-home mum. I've been a full-time worker. I'm now kind of almost full-time again. For me, the times I've been happiest when I've got the balance right.
Yes.
And but it never lasts long.
No, you know, and the balance...
Kind of, oh, you've got it, I've got it, like you said, boardroom.
And then everything
shifts. And then it goes again.
Yeah. And I think